please stand. I wonder if I'm that person. I guess I'll find out later on in his service. Good morning.
Good morning.
You are First United Methodist Church in Chanute. Thank you for your presence today. They did. They paid attention. You notice they have red on. That's pretty neat. But you also came in with one other thing. Do you know what that is? What you came in with also outside just being dressed in red? Absolutely. He came in the door with you. Of course, he has always been here, but he came in the door with you to greet you today. He came in with open arms, saying, "Come, here I am." And you know what? Here you are. Sunday, the Lord's Day. The easiest thing you'll do all day long is come through those doors and spend an hour here. The easiest thing you do is that if you have wants and desires, and hurts and ills, joys and concerns, you came to the right place. This is a good place. This is a good place to share a friendship with other Christians. It is. It's a good day, isn't it? It's an awesome day. It's the one the Lord has made. It says, the opening hymn is number 2088. Lord, I lift your name on high. Would you please stand if you can?
The other announcements this morning.
seat of red. Even got Don and George wearing red. My gosh. So, if there are no other announcements this morning, it's time to stand up fast.
To us. We are so blessed. So I invite you to bow your heads. Fold your hands and repeat this prayer with me. Almighty God, we thank you for all of our blessings. Amen. See you next week.
Thank you.
morning, and some very close friends of theirs, I guess, the father was out cutting down a tree, and his son was with him, and the tree fell on the little four-year-old. They life-flighted him to Children's Mercy. He has a cracked skull from ear to ear and a broken clavicle. So we need to keep that family in our prayers. Stevenson's, I think that I said it. Stenson's? Lee and Sue Stanson's grandson is who it is. Also, I told you about a boy, one of my former youth groupers, Connor Kiefer. They are trying a new form of therapy. He is currently home on oxygen. He will not be able to go to school. He has to stay inside on oxygen and monitors all day. And every month, 3 days, he has to go for IV treatments. They are going to try this, so prayers that it will work and he will respond to the treatment.
Okay. And my wife has one.
My joy for this morning is it seems like the last few weeks we just keep hearing, you know, diagnosis of cancers and treatments. I want a good news cancer story at Kathy Buckley. I heard that she has had two of her infusion treatments for breast cancer, and this week they decided to see if the two treatments are being effective, and they said best case scenario was to have them stay the same and not grow, and there were three spots. And so the radiographer looked at it, and he's like, the three are getting smaller, and we can't find anything on the lymph node that was concerned. So he brought in another technologist to review it because he didn't think that was likely. He said, no, don't even worry about the lymph node, it's good. And the three are shrinking. So that's a cancer joy.
And we have several folks in the back of the bulletin we need to keep in our prayers. So.
The latest on Keith, Keith is home. Keep him in your prayers because they found nothing. And it was very scary, life-threatening what happened to Keith. So keep Keith in our prayers.
Okay. What else this morning? You got something?
This is my sister's first time accolading.
Anybody else?
If God can let us prepare with our hand, God is so good, we will do all four mercies.
Thank you.
service. May they be a blessing unto your sight and used according to your will. Amen.
You know, there's a lot to be said about what happens next in this service. And if you really paid attention to the very beginning, you would have heard the term children's sermon. And you would have heard the things about other blessings. This is about the other blessings. It's found in Matthew 5, verses 1 through 12. Jesus saw the crowds. He went up on the mountainside and sat down. His disciples came to him, and he began to teach them. He said, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. They will be filled." Here's one that hits me. "Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people insult you, persecute you, and falsely say all kinds of evil against you because of me." Because of me. "Rejoice and be glad, because great is your reward in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." This is the good news for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Oh my God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. Lord God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. Over the centuries and thousands of years, celebrities, in a way, have replaced heroes. Wealth, admirations, even notoriety has replaced what it means to be a hero. So over time, we are starting to go gaga over people like Lady Gaga. It is easy to do. So what do we do with scriptures like we have before us today? Blessed are the poor in spirit. Blessed are those who mourn. Blessed are the meek. You see, Jesus was early in his ministry, and he was going out, and he was starting to bring in disciples and followers. And here, he meets a whole group of people, and he gives a famous sermon, the Sermon on the Mount. It's an interesting sight. When I was in Israel, I wanted so bad to go to the area, where he gave the Sermon on the Mount. So I was like, how did they hear him? And let me tell you, they would have heard him. The sound effect qualities there are amazing. It was a slope. He would have been preaching off the water towards the slope where all the people were gathered. Now, the second point is, it is so hard to preach a sermon on the best sermon there is. I want to try, and how I'm going to do this is by breaking it apart, blessing after blessing. Now, I want to point out that the Greek word for blessed can be broken down as happy. If you are blessed, you are happy. If you are happy, you are blessed. So let's begin with the top three. Blessed are the humble, the grieving, but powerless. Now, when you take, for instance, the celebrities, and when you think about what they have, you consider maybe they are blessed, maybe they are happy, but throughout time, we know that this is not always the case. So we read the scripture before us today. Blessed are the humble, the greedy, the powerless. How is that seen as a blessing? Well, let's start with humble. Blessed or happy are those who are humble. Now, I want to point out and say, people that are humble, sometimes the word humiliated is placed with that. And I want to say to you that, no, that is not the fact. Because blessed are those who are humble. Another way to say it is blessed are those who let God work through them. Instead of them taking all of the joy, all of the notoriety, all of the praise, instead, they're saying, God, thanks to you, I can do these things. Happy are those, blessed are those who point out that fact. Secondly, blessed or happy are those who grieve. I struggle sometimes with this one. Because in times of loss, when I have lost someone, I look at it as, I'm not very happy. I don't feel blessed losing somebody. But then when you look at it in a whole circular fashion, when we are part of the body of Christ, what happens when we are grieving? What happens when we lose somebody? What happens when we are sad? When we are part of the body of Christ, what do we have? We have friends. We have God, right? God, you can say it. This is a joint effort. I have a hand in here up here. One of our young ones gets it. We have each other to grieve together with. If you do not have God, if God doesn't have your back, if you're not part of the body of Christ, and if you're out there alone, mourning, grieving, sad, yes, it would be hard to find a blessing amongst that time. But when the community is with you and you're leaning on each other, blessed are you. Third, blessed or happy are the powerless. Blessed are the powerless. Why would you be blessed in this moment? Because if you are powerless, if you release your power and let God take over, then we erase the margins. We get rid of those divides and we work together. We are together fully as the body of Christ. And if we are to take the message of the gospel seriously, then we will begin and strive to create a world where the powerless amongst us are brought into the fullness of the world. They are brought into the fullness of the world, and we all work together as one. Fourth, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for the righteousness, for they will be fulfilled. Now, in my language classes in seminary, many times righteousness was also seen as justice. But blessed are those who hunger for justice. Blessed are those who seek justice, who sees injustice in the world and tries to bring forth righteousness and justice. Are you seeing a theme here? So pretty much we are getting away of self and putting as we are not to be living into corruption and into the worldly ways. Instead, we are to be stepping out of those ways and living as God wants us to live. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. People, peace is not passive. It's not. Peace is not false unity. It is not that which silences oppression. Peace does not mask injustice and allows it to fester. No, peacemaking is hard work. It is daily active work. And we are called into it. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs will be the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who are persecuted for living a side of justice, who lives inside of integrity. You see, striving to be merciful and living a just life and spreading justice throughout the world is not going to make you popular in some circles. When you stand up for the innate worth that's found in everybody, there will be some that comes after you. And finally, blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you. Again, it is not an easy road. Do not expect success by the measures of this world. That's part of that humility, that humble portion. There will be days that seems you struggle to be happy, but your reward will come one day when we meet our Maker, our Lord Jesus Christ. So in summing up, blessed are those who work through God, who loves each other, who lives outside of the margins, who seeks justice, who works for mercy, who lives through integrity, and who seeks peace with a calm presence to those who you are around. Blessed are they. Are you blessed? Christ gave himself up on the cross, he took the bread, he blessed it, he gave it to his disciples and said, take and eat of this. This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When the meal was over, he took the cup, blessed it, gave it to the disciples and said, take, drink from this all of you. This is my cup poured out for you for the forgiveness of sins. Drink this in remembrance of me. Let us pray. Almighty God, pour out your Holy Spirit on us who are gathered here, and on these gifts of bread and cup. May they be for us the body and the blood of Christ, a symbol of your mercy and your redemption. May we in turn be your hands and feet, the ones to deliver your message of good news to the world. In Christ. Christ's name. Amen. Those who are helping with communion may come forward at this time. Let us pray. Almighty God, we give you thanks for your mercy and grace that's extended to us through this simple meal. Amen. Let us stand and sing together. This is Holy Father's World. Overflow and overshadow you. Amen.